everyone, and welcome to Devotions with the Dubes. I am Tanil Dube.
And I am Mandla Dube. So today we're going to continue with our devotion to the book of Samuel, 1 Samuel. And last time we looked at chapter 8, where we saw the Israelites coming to Samuel and saying that they want a king. And God said to Samuel that he must grant the people their wish and give them a king. And now this week in chapter 9, we're introduced to a potential king. His name is Saul.
And so in chapter 9, it opens by telling us about a man named Kish. And Kish was a man of power. He was influential and he was wealthy. And he was from the tribe of Benjamin. His son's name was Saul. And I want to read verse 2. It says, "His son Saul was the most handsome man in Israel, head and shoulders taller than anyone else in the land." And like Mandla said in the previous chapter, the Israelites were asking for a king. And when we look at this, we were thinking, you know, Saul has the outward appearance of a king. And it tells a story of one day Kish's donkeys went astray. They went missing. And he sent Saul and a servant out to look for his donkeys. And in verse 4 it says, "So Saul took one of the servants and traveled through the hill country of Ephraim, the land of Salisa, the Salem area, and the entire land of Benjamin, but they couldn't find the donkeys anywhere. Finally, they entered the region of Zoph, and Saul said to his servant, 'Let's go home. By now, my father will be more worried about us than about the donkeys.'"
Yeah, they go all over the towns looking for the donkeys, and they can't find them. And the servant has an idea that he has heard of a man of God, a prophet or a seer, who is able to see things and who has had prophecies, and those prophecies have come to pass. So he says, maybe if we go to him, we might get help, and he might be able to show us which way to go to look for the donkeys. But they have a problem because now they've used all their resources, so they don't have a gift for the prophet or the seer. So it was custom for them in that time, whenever you go to a man of God or a seer or a prophet, to bring a gift to them as a thank you gift or as a gift to honor them. And they didn't have it. But this is what the servant says in verse 8. "The servant answered him again, 'Look,' he said, 'I have a quarter of a shekel of silver. I will give it to the man of God so that he will tell us what way to take.'" So now they've got some money with them, and they say that they are going to give it to the man of God. And so they go to a town of Ramah where Samuel was staying. And on their way there, they meet young women who were drawing water from the well. And they ask them if Samuel was in the area. And they reply in verse 12, they say, "He is," they answered. "He is ahead of you. Hurry now. He has just come to our town today, for the people have a sacrifice at the high place. And as soon as you enter the town, you will find him before he goes up to the high place to eat. The people will not begin eating until he comes, because he must bless the sacrifice. Afterwards, those who are invited will eat. Go up now, and you should find him about this time."
And in so verse 15, it says, "Now the Lord had told Samuel the previous day, 'About this time tomorrow, I will send you a man from the land of Benjamin. Anoint him to be the leader of my people Israel. He will rescue them from the Philistines, for I have looked down on my people in mercy and have heard their cry.'" And it's so fascinating to us that the Lord was speaking to Samuel the day before the donkeys had gone missing. And we know that it's the donkeys that brought Saul to the town. But the Lord was speaking to Samuel the day before, saying that Saul would come to this town. And it just reminds us that when you're going to do God's work, when you're going to do the work of his kingdom, he paves the way before you. He goes before you. And in verse 17, it says that God confirmed to Samuel that Saul was the man that he was talking about in his prophecy when he said that a man from the land of Benjamin would be coming to them. And in verse 20, it says, "And don't worry about those donkeys that were lost 3 days ago, for they have been found." So Samuel was saying to Saul that the donkeys have already been found. And this was indicating that Samuel was a prophet. Just like Mandla said, they were going to Samuel because they knew that he was a prophet. And he was proving that he was a true prophet. And at the end of the same verse, it says, "And I am here to tell you that you and your family are the focus of all Israel's hope." And Samuel here was hinting to Saul about the prophecy. And then Saul replies, "But I am only from the tribe of Benjamin, the smallest tribe in Israel, and my family is the least important of all the families of that tribe. Why are you talking to me like this?" And when we see here, Saul is saying that he's from the smallest tribe. He's saying that his family is the least important. But if we go back to verse 1, it said that his father was a wealthy and influential man. And so we see that Saul here is being humble. And it just reminds us of the scripture in Matthew chapter 23 and verse 12, where it says, "Those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted."
Yeah. And we see straight when he arrives that Samuel prepares a place for Saul in a special place at the table. He sits at the head of the table along with the 30 other guests. When we look in verse 22, that's what it says. It says that he set him in a special place with 30 other guests that were there. But it doesn't end there. It says, the Bible tells us in the next verse that it actually even gets an even more meat than the rest of the people, a special portion of meat than the rest of the people, to show him that he's actually is the chosen one, and he is the one who is to take over the kingdom of the Israelites. And when you go further, it says that he actually Samuel speaks to Saul, and it says as they were going down to the edge of the town after they've had dinner the following day, it says, as they were going to the edge of the town, Samuel said to Saul, "Tell the servant to go on ahead of us." And the servant did so. "But you stay here a while so that I may give you a message from God." And it is such a beautiful thing that something that looks like it was an annoying, normal situation where they've lost the donkeys and they're looking for the donkeys. But God is using that very situation to usher Saul into the place where he wants him to be, where he wants to make him a king over Israel. And I can't help but wonder that even in our lives, we can see some situations that are happening. We can see things happening and we wonder, why is this happening? But sometimes it's just God working it out for us to come to the place where he wants us to be.
Yeah, and something really beautiful that Mandla and I were thinking about when we read the scripture is that the donkeys went astray, and it was the donkeys that brought Saul into the city. And later we'll read in the next chapters how Saul becomes the first king of Israel. And we just think of our king, King Jesus, who was also brought into the city by a donkey, and we just see the parallels there. But we also we're just thinking of, you know, times in our lives when everything seemed like it was going wrong, and in the end we see that it was all leading up to the perfect plan of the Lord. So we just want to encourage you to trust the Lord, and even in difficult situations, trust that the Lord has good plans for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. And trust in the Lord even in good situations, just as the Lord unfolds his will in your life. And we just want to bless you guys.
God bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you.